The lingering baby formula shortage is worsening and leaving many parents in desperation. Recall and supply chain issues are being blamed for the ongoing shortage, and several major retailers like Walgreens and CVS are limiting parents to purchasing just one can at a time. Many parents are anxious, scared, and worried about how to feed their babies as store shelves remain empty. Dr. Julie Holland, Vice President of Pediatric Primary Care for the Chicagoland Children's Health Alliance, joins us now to discuss just that. Doctor, a pleasure having you here.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. So kicking things off here, what should parents do if they just can't find their baby's formula and they're coming down to their last or two final cans?
So for the vast majority of babies, they can eat most infant formulas. And so there are a lot of generic and store brand equivalents to the main formulas. I know for most parents, they find a formula that they really like. It works well for their babies and they want to stick with it. But if their particular brand that they use is in short supply, Target, Walmart, several other major retailers have equivalent formulas as well. And those are FDA regulated. And so those are safe and those are fine to use. So I think for a lot of parents, they may just have to go outside of their comfort zone a little bit and perhaps switch to a different brand. But again, Abbott Labs is the formula company that's most in short supply because of the manufacturing problems, but there are other manufacturers in the market that parents can use. For babies that have special needs, say very premature babies or babies who are allergic to certain things or intolerant of certain foods, those babies are often on specialized formula and it can be a little bit more difficult for those parents. But your pediatrician is here to help. Call your pediatrician or your specialist and really talk about which other formula brands might be appropriate for your child as well.
A lot of parents may also be trying to go online, finding different places. What are some of the dangers of going into, say, places like the black market or just other not necessarily certified retailers when purchasing the formula?
Right. So formula has to be stored at certain temperatures for it to remain effective and for all the proteins and nutrients to be in place. So you really have no control if you're buying over how your formula has been stored. If it's been stored in very hot bins or containers or in freezing cold circumstances, if some of the stuff is inactivated, there are lots of reasons to not buy secondhand or black market formula. And so I would really encourage parents to just stick with the major retailers. If they get formula from another source, they really need to check and make sure that the can does not appear to have been tampered with, that the expiration date is funny looking about it, like things aren't misspelled on the labels or other things that really show that it may be something different. You have no idea what's in that can if you're buying something off the black market, but if you buy it from a major retailer, the FDA and the retailer have made sure that formula comes to you in a safe and effective formula.
Browsing online, you know, different community pages and parent pages, something that keeps popping up and it doesn't seem right, but you can probably help explain just the dangers behind it is people saying, you know, well, hey, here's the recipe that my grandmother used back in, you know, who knows when, and we grew up perfectly fine. What are the dangers of making those homemade formulas?
Yeah, so homemade formulas should be avoided. There are lots of reasons that we have gone to this highly regulated type of formula in the U.S., and the growth and nutrition of your baby really depends on them getting the right foods. And almost all of these homemade formulas have inadequate iron or inadequate something else or too much protein or too much sodium. You really cannot make at home a formula that is nutritionally appropriate for your baby, so stay away from them. They're not safe.
Yeah, and when it comes to proper nutrition, how soon or at what age can parents start introducing other fruits, veggies, and whole pieces?
Well, so parents can start introducing baby food, meaning the pureed baby food, not necessarily chunks, but pureed food at 4 to 6 months of age. And most kids progress through fruits and vegetables and grains and that can be at 4 to 6 months of age. And most pediatricians encourage babies to start eating at that age. And that, again, takes a little bit of pressure off babies who are that age because they can get nutrition from other means other than just from formula.
Well, Doctor, always a pleasure having you on. Thank you so much for giving us the latest on this information. I know many parents out there scrambling to find a couple cans, but a message to parents, you know, if they do find a couple cans, say on their local grocery store shelves, like you had mentioned earlier, be courteous.
Right. Part of the reason there's a shortage is that we have a lot of bulk buying. So people are trying to stock up on several months at a time, which just makes the problem worse for everybody else. So most retailers are restricting the number of cans you can buy, but I think it's just really important for all of us. This is definitely a we're all in this together moment. Mm-hmm. So buy what you need, but don't overbuy and make it make the situation worse for everybody else. And the last thing I just wanted to say before I forget is there's one thing that you should never give a baby under a year of age, and that's honey. So that's a big no-no in anything that they're eating.
There we go. Dr. Holland, thank you so much for taking the time to share all this information with us. We really do appreciate it.
You're welcome.